shoot him, guys. You.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh.
Cool.
I think we took a hit, so we lost points at some point there, but... Hey, 4 skulls. That's not bad for where I am in the game.
So, the orcs are dancing to this woman's thing that makes orcs dance. Well, I can make orcs dance too. And by dance, I mean die when I poke them with my blade staff. This just doesn't seem fair.
Okay. This should be a sufficient setup, I think. It's so spread out here, but there's so many of them that I can still catch all of them with all my freeze balls.
They're in the West Hall.
This is a lot of ground to cover with traps, so it might be better to here. We need some steel. Phew. Okay. Is there a good central location where I can put you? Hey, maybe I can string them along even further than I thought. Maybe if I put a thing here, they'll say, oh, let's go this way. What I'm already doing on the other side. Besides, the way that I'm doing it lets me have a kill. I don't know where I would put it if I did. See, I actually am getting killed.
Doesn't seem fair.
May you fight my numberless horde until the end of your days, little one. Submit.
Oh, please don't send me more orc scary woman's voice. How could I possibly?
I'm not being quiet to let you hear those two, you know, gibber at each other. Because you kind of can't. At the end of the day, very difficult to hear them talk. Like, the fact, because, like, they're talking during the level. Which means that the only way to, like, hear them talk is to be playing the level. But you need them you know, to be quiet. You need everything else to be quiet, but, you know, there's 1,000 orcs dying here. Throw those guys down. Oh, you're the guys from the left who come over here, huh? Hook them off with a freeze thing is pretty underappreciated. It's a lot of fun. Woo! Where are you guys going? Looks like they're like stuck in a loop over here. Let me grab this coin, please. Thank you. What is that, 100?
That's how it's done.
What have okay.
You nice.
Let's go with you.
You made the right decision. Burn an orc for me.
And then let's put 2 on that side and 2 on this side. I don't want you guys to hurt my archers too much, so I'm just gonna put some hurt on you. Oh man! So many over here. Also, damn, that's unfortunate. Alright, hey guys, what's going on? I'm pretty sure that those things run over barricades as well. In case you were curious as to why I didn't use any smarter to combat them. Gnolls are a problem. They're a big problem. There's a hornet drop over here. Thanks for holding it down over here, man.
Oh, that was fun.
That's illegal. The kobolds, they kind of do present a very interesting challenge gameplay-wise, because, like, they can't hurt you, and they won't, in fact. The only kobold that can hurt you is the one that has a bomb strapped to its back. And I think those ones might even run slower. I can't even remember if they did. I might be making that up. But yeah, they're only, a kobold's only way of actually damaging you through some, you know, silly stuff like that. And properly speaking, a kobold's only issue is to do that. And so, like, there's not that many fast enemies in this game. The gnolls are fast, but I think the kobolds are fast. But they both present interesting challenges gameplay-wise. Because they force the player to confront things outside of the typical paradigm. I'm gonna get over here. Right, I wanted to switch these things position. I wanted to lengthen it out. So, we can start to get a kill zone here. cut through more guys that way, you know?
Oh yeah. Good times. Good times.
Yep. We're not good, but we'll survive. All right, kill zone's working. I wonder if there's been ever been like any real tower defenses in real life. I guess like in the War of the Roses, a lot of towers in Britain that you would need to defend, such as it is. Put another barricade here, but that means that they have to zigzag, and that'll take them slightly longer. This feels good, man. Just kicking a bunch of things into the pit. This is what the boom barrels are for, right?
Picnic time.
Well, I've got some spare cash, so wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Seven. Kinda like seeing the kobolds get lit up. I don't know why kobolds of all things have such a big like disagreement about. Because in some worlds, kobolds are little dragons, and in some of them, they're little rats. And sometimes the distinction is... Okay, good. Traps are working. Sometimes the distinction is, like, so similar that it's, like, whatever. Like, they just kind of look like both. But I don't know why that is. I personally think I like dragon kobolds better than rat kobolds. Chewing through them. Yeah, this is a little, Hey, if I put a barricade here, does it force them to go through there? I guess it would have to, wouldn't it? Because I was thinking maybe there's a way that I can get this path to not be such a straight shot. So maybe I can replicate all of this on the other side. And force them over there. Or maybe I do this. Maybe I block this up completely. And then I open the gate over there. Oh man, that's bad. Alright, see, what happens is you freeze him with a spell, and then the timer for him getting unfrozen starts ticking down. So even though you hit him with a spell a second time, it doesn't actually stop him from moving any longer than it would already. The timer's the same. So you can't just, like, freeze lock a guy. You can't stun lock him like that.
That was fun.
way that I can, like, get long with this. Like, if I block this here, then they run out of that room. And then they'd say, oh, man, we can't go that way either, so we have to go through the middle. And then they'd run into this kill zone, which is where I blocked this enemy. Oh, crap, more gnolls. Gnolls are no joke, legit, one of my least favorite fantasy creatures. I wrote this series, you may have actually seen it. Oh god, that's so much senseless waste of life. Not these orcs, the guys I care about. I wrote this fantasy series, then I turned it into a radio show, and then I put it on the internet for some reason. You can actually go watch it. I don't know if I would recommend it, but yeah, you can. It's called Asher's Journal, and it's basically like, what if a zombie apocalypse. It sounds so stupid as I'm saying it out loud. Oh man, they're getting it. But it was going so well. Oh, it was just two guys who snuck in. God. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Sweet!
Okay. So, if we knock that all out.
How about some of this?
And we do that. They turn around. And they go through here, yeah. And then they go straight up here. Okay, well that's fine. But we can extend this kill zone here.
The last thing you'll ever see. Something for your
and
face.
Force them all the way I through like this little this maze, in fact. That would make sure that they don't trigger this one early, or at least that one. But anyway, it was basically about like a zombie apocalypse happening in like a fantasy world. But whereas most zombie apocalypses are like pretty straight up and down, like scientific, and usually viral. Even if it's not literally a virus, it'll be a virus analog. Like a fungus, bacteria, you know. When I say virus, I don't necessarily literally mean the factual viral agent. You know, trope-wise, if you say the virus, people will know that you mean the infectious thing that is causing a danger to people around. Oh. Actually, that's... yeah, and then now we have this nice little thing we're moving through. Yeah, light them up. But anyway, the quote-unquote virus was completely magical. And while there was an infectious nature, because I feel like that's... Infection in a zombie sense is very much a important part of modern zombie myth, I believe. And like that is fun. I feel like I'd be kind of remiss to not have it. But anyway. Oops, I'm in the wrong room. Pardon me, fellas. One of the things with it was let's put a kill here.
A little present for you. One for you.
Then we can extend that out.
One for you.
Force them along that way. But anyway, the actual problem was that there was like people were gaining like a mythic connection to the god of hunger. Which, if you didn't know, is actually the D&D lore for why gnolls are like. they have a god of hunger. The one on this side? Great, that's what I love to see. Oh god. Oh, it doesn't take it out in one. Huh. Really would have thought that that would be the case. Armored ogre, much more hit points, of course. It's on account of that armor, you see. Anyway, the D&D lore for why gnolls are like they are is because they all have this psychic connection to a god of hunger, and they all become like avatars of his will. Oh god. Oh no. Oh jeez. And they're just compelled to eat, just consume anything, no matter what it is. Oh yeah. Brutal. Where'd you go, man? Turn around. Cool. But yeah, so I wrote them. So I wrote the zombies as being like essentially like a gnoll, in that they're linked to a god of hunger, and when they eat, the god eats as well. But the god is always hungry because it's a god of hunger, and they're just driven, forced to continually scrape and grind and chew away at every possible piece of meat that they can.
She was
this is the sorceress. She's the main villain. I'm gonna skip the cutscene. Sorry. Oh god, this level.
Well, to start with, you're really arrogant and you talk like a history book.
But yeah, she and the War Mage gibber at each other in
I will break you.
In dialogue.
You sound just like the old man.
This will hurt.
Maybe cuter.
You are the last of the old.
Just for you.
So yeah, this is that sanctum stuff that I'm getting into here, where like you actually build full mazes. I'm still unsure if it would be smart to do a playthrough. Oh, I hate these guys. Those dudes, they resurrect the dead. I think so. Right. Oh, good. I was kind of worried that they were just gonna.
This won't hurt.
Yeah, I was worried that they were gonna open a new door on me. Yeah. You see that green mist, and that dude just got up? Yeah. Enemy medics, man. Revivers. You know, ask anyone, what's the worst enemy in Doom? And then specify Doom 2, because it's technically a separate game, and they don't appear in any of the levels in Doom 1. But ask anyone what the worst enemy in Doom is, and they'll probably tell you the Archvile. You know, even in the instruction manual, it literally refers to the Archvile as the worst of a bad bunch. Nope. You gotta go, man. Hate it when that happens. Like, we've lost a barricade not because they're rushing the barricade, but just because they just hit it while walking by.
What have you got?
We'll make a good team.
Excellent.
Don't waste what I've given you.
Okay. We're gonna need to set it up here.
Oh,
Okay. Okay. Oh, geez. 16. I need more to set up a new barricade on the other side. Oh, doesn't get a choice anyway.
That's gonna leave a mark.
Also, I set it up backwards, so that's great. Okay. Please hold the line. Oh god, I have so much more of a line to hold over here. Too, right. That's right. Oh, man. Oh, I'm getting smashed here. Because these guys keep picking up guys. Oh. I could have sold all this. All this is not doing me favors.
Oh, yeah. I'm awesome.
That guy just fell over. All right. Okay. Might get a game over here, but that'll be okay. The point of the kill zone is so I can swing through a whole bunch of them in one go. It's meant to be the point of it. Oh, jeez. No! Where's the next one going? Where's it coming from? I think they only get one, which I guess is good, but like, ugh. Let's put some more. Well, we can do some more killing down here as well. Actually have some damage up. Now the other side needs my assistance directly. Spent too much time over there. Oh boy. God, getting through on one skull. I don't know what I'm doing over here. Let's just... Let's just load up, you know? And we've hit the limit.
This'll be fun.
don't like how those guys are out.
Yep.
Oh, jeez. Okay, got you down.
God!
Yeah, it's bad over there. They take a break.